Hello everyone, welcome to my channel World of AWS. I hope you all are doing good. So we are continuing with GitLab CI/CD tutorial, and in last video we have seen like how we can create simple pipeline, and in this video we are going to discuss about how we can like troubleshoot our pipeline if our pipeline is not working. Okay, so there is some basic scenario I have written. So apart from it, we are also going to see some more scenario that lead to error in our pipeline. Okay, so no spaces after hyphen. Okay, so like echo, bad indentation, forgetting to add colon. Okay, so this is the main things. Okay, but let me show you some more detail as well. Okay, and in real time. So I have created the pipeline here. So let me open this and click on edit, click on Bev ID. So here is our pipeline. Okay, so suppose, so if we change this file name, our pipeline file name, from .gitlab-ci.yml to anything, it will not work. Okay, our pipeline will not get started. So suppose I am removing the dot here, so it's YAML, it's became YAML, and let me commit it. I have committed. So let's go to the build to check the pipeline, and here we can get the option like pipeline, right? And there is no pipeline get triggered. Okay, because we like change the pipeline file name, and that is not considered and not recognized by the GitLab. That's why it's not, our pipeline is not even getting started. Okay, so let me rename it and let me commit this again. Okay, so as you can see here, our pipeline is just get started and our pipeline is running. So to check the pipeline, we have to click on this pipeline ID, and to check the commit, whatever changes have been made in this commit, we have to click on this commit ID. Okay, and this is the branch where this pipeline is running. Okay, so as you can see here, we have changed from this to this, right? The pipeline file name. So go here and click on this pipeline and as you can see here, our build and test both stages are getting successful and our pipeline not having any error. Okay, so let me go here and let me type some random command that is not valid. Okay, so tsgg, I have given the some random command that is not valid, and let me commit this. Go to the pipeline again, go to the build, then go to the pipeline. So as you can see here, our pipeline is working, but build is failed and test is not even getting started, because it this considered that if our build stage is successful, then only test stage will get triggered. Okay, but if our build get fail, then test will not get executed. Okay, so I have written this here, so let me remove this. Okay, and let me type some random command here and let me commit this. So go to the pipeline again, go to the build, and our pipeline is running, right? So as we can see here, build is successful now and test is running. It will get failed because we have given some random command in a script, okay? So that is not valid. So that's why our pipeline is getting failed on test stage, okay? And job failed exist code is 127, right? It means our script is getting failed. So as you can see here, bin bash eval line 145 and gapha not found, right? So whatever command we have written, that is, that name is gapha, okay? So this is not a valid command, that's why our pipeline is getting failed, okay? So bad indentation means, like, let me show you. If we gave some extra space, okay, so some extra space, then let me commit this, our pipeline will not work. So go here, go to the pipelines, and you can see here just now it get failed because YAML is invalid, right? It's saying YAML is invalid. So in this case we have to look for the error, like where we have given the extra space, bad indentation or something like that, okay? So let me commit this again and our pipeline will get triggered again, okay? So let me refresh it, and as you can see our pipeline started running, right? So it will get successful because our pipeline doesn't have any error and issue, okay? So all things are valid in our pipeline. So apart from it, we have seen, like, we have to give the pipeline file name, that is .gitlab-ci.yml, okay? So you have to make sure your GitLab CI/CD pipeline file name is this, okay, look like this. Apart from it, if you give anything, your pipeline is not going to work, okay? And make sure you are giving the valid command, and make sure you are not making any bad indentation, you are not giving some extra space, okay? So these are the some common cases that leads to error in our pipeline, okay? So if our pipeline is getting failed, okay, then what we need to do, like, we need to look for the error that will be shown here, okay, in the logs. We need to look for that error and we need to understand it, like, what is causing the issue. So we need to resolve, and we need to look for the resolution according to that specific log, okay? So apart from it, we are also going to see advanced cases that lead to error in our pipeline in upcoming videos. So that's it for this video, okay? So I hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you have any query regarding this video and this topic, then let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.